or been awarded. The Department of Natural Resources and the State Historic Preservation Office, they awarded an $8,100 grant towards a citywide, well, not complete citywide, but if you look at the map here, this includes Cottage Grove on the east, up to Rosewood Drive on the north, Osteopathy on the west, and La Harpe on the south, excluding the downtown, and that's because there's currently there is a grant right now in the downtown to have a historic preservation survey, and that was funded through Community Development Block Grant for $12,000. But we were awarded this $8,100 grant to complete a historic and architectural resource survey plan, and the plan will identify historic contexts that outline the development of Kirksville and historic trends that affected its growth and physical developments. The plan will mostly be used as an educational tool, helping citizens better understand the history and historic character of the city and their building or their home if they do, in fact, live in a historic home. It'll be used by the city and the Kirksville Historic Preservation Commission to set priorities for targeting preservation efforts and funding, including planning and future grant applications. The plan will also include sufficient historical background to evaluate significance under National Register criteria, with descriptions and property analysis for proposed historic districts. And again, I already told you what the area that will be surveyed, and the grant for fiscal impact, the grant agreement requires the city to document $2,900 of in-kind match, which will be not a problem, and $2,500 cash. It would just be a fantastic tool because the downtown, it's currently being surveyed, and we look forward to that final plan, which we hope by the end of this month we'll be able to send that to the Kirksville Historic Preservation Commission, and then this one will basically take up everything else in the city. So it'll be a nice plan and survey tool that everybody can use. If they want to do some exterior renovations, they could use that to document what they have.
So when is the expected completion of the survey?
Of this particular one?
Uh-huh.
Well, if you all approve it, we will then send out requests for proposals by Friday. And we hope to get those back within 2 weeks. And then we will notify the consultant who does win the RFP. And but this has to be closed out by September of 2011. So in DNR, they keep us on a very tight deadline. So it'll start this summer.
You know, Sheree, I hadn't asked you about this, but when the council was talking about the Battle of Kirksville, mm-hmm. and where that battle actually took place, mm-hmm. Part of this would identify the historical significance of that and some possible locations, wouldn't it?
Well, I suppose it could potentially. I do know that the one that we currently have in progress is primarily focused on buildings.
On the structures.
And structures. And this one mirrors that as well.
Yeah, and I was just going by the fact, you know, on the map it said preservation sites. I was not really looking at the agreement itself, but it just struck me.
Yeah,
just
I think that, yeah, and you know, I think that map is titled incorrectly.
Okay.
But that is the area that we'll be focusing on for structures and buildings. But you know, whoever wins the award, we could definitely talk to him or her about that and see what we could do.
Any other comments or questions for Sheree? Mm-hmm. All right, I'll call the vote then. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. Next item, bill number 2010-23.
An ordinance approving a settlement agreement with Altel.
So moved.
Second.
All right.
You know, some of you have seen these settlement agreements before, because over the last few years, it seems like we've had, this is our fifth one, so sometimes they come close together. So, but what we'd like you to think about and approve is to allow the city manager to authorize our participation and a settlement that Altel has offered to the city of Kirksville for back taxes, payment of back taxes on their wireless services that they have provided. And actually, this is from September 1st, 2005 through March 31st of 2009 is what they would like to settle. Along with the settlement, if we accept it, they have calculated that what they owe us is $129,204.26 in back taxes. If we settle, then they will also start paying us any taxes in the future also on wireless, provision of wireless services. And like I mentioned, this is the fifth wireless company that has made a settlement with the city and with other municipalities throughout the state. We are not alone. All the municipalities have participated in these class action lawsuits. So.
When will we be scheduled to receive the funds?
I believe they're supposed to settle by June, end of June. So. Usually it's a couple months out. It's just that we have deadlines that we need to get this claim form back to them. So.
Any other questions or comments? I'll call the vote. All those in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Laura. Bill number 2010-24.
An ordinance repealing and amending certain sections of Chapter 14, Article 5, Farmers Market of the Code of the City of Kirksville, Missouri.
So moved.
Well, as you know from a previous council meeting, there have been some discussions between Kiwanis and the City of Kirksville about Farmers Market. And the outcome of that was a series of recommendations from Kiwanis on how to change the ordinance, and then City taking a look at it and then restructuring it so that it's more reflective of the changes that we're making at the present time. So I took a stab at putting some of the stuff into writing, and then the city manager and the city clerk repaired my stuff and made it better and everything like that. So that's why we're here today, is to put forward those recommendations principally from Kiwanis in reference to the farmer's market.
It just to kind of go over the most significant, did establish the purpose of farmer's market. There was not really anything that spelled out, you know, what was it all about. We also made some consistent language changes because of the hours. There were different hours depending upon where you looked in the ordinance. There was also a provision added giving the Kiwanis designee or representative the ability to deny the use of the farmer's market to someone. It gives them the right themselves, as opposed to, you know, calling me or asking the police to come up. They can do that on their own. And it also, they established some changes in terms of where the items could come from. Fresh produce has to be grown within a 50-mile radius. It cannot come from Mexico and be sold to farmers market. They wanted to add USDA-inspected meat and fish. There was a change made on the eggs, and that was simply because the city clerk had found that there was state law requirements regarding the dealer's license in order to be able to sell eggs. So some of the changes were also just to reflect current state law. And we did share this with the Kiwanis chairman of the farmers market. She's reviewed that several times, and I think those are the significant changes.
Comments here if we have any. The president of Kiwanis is here if we have any questions.
And from last week's citizen participation, they agreed to leave the farmers market on Nelson Street where it's been currently, so that was something brought up last week.
And I think actually what we did is we just, it said Elson or the courthouse parking lot, or it was red where it could go on the courthouse, and so we made it where it's Elson is the primary location.
Any more comments or discussion from the council? Any comments or discussion from citizens? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries.